Bonjour et bienvenue à cette mini-lecture pour Français 112 à CSI. Bonjour and welcome to this mini-lecture, the last of this semester, for French 112, Basic French 1 at the College of Staten Island City, University of New York. The topic of this lecture is les verbes en ER irréguliers. These specific irregular verbs are irregular because they have what is called a spelling change. So that spelling change occurs in the stems of several different groups, and we're going to see several different instances of these spelling irregularities. Remember what the stem of a verb is, right? When you conjugate a verb, you have a stem, which is the part that usually does not change, and then the endings, which change according to the subject, right? So, je has a specific ending, tu has a specific ending, etc., etc. Now, what is nice to know is that these specific spelling changes, and they're going to seem like a lot at first, they actually reflect the pronunciation. So when you hear these verbs, you hear the correct spelling. And as you might have guessed, these irregularities have to do with accents. And so we'll do a quick review of accents today as well. Now, this is important because verbs that are irregular in such a way are verbs like espérer, to hope, préférer, to prefer, to like best, acheter, to buy, essayer, to try, payer, to pay, voyager, to travel, manger, to eat, nager, to swim. You already know some of those. You've already been using them. So this lesson here is going to take us back and make sure that we are spelling those verbs correctly when we're conjugating them. The first group is verbs like espérer. So espérer means to hope. And if you look at the table there, you see the irregularity. And you see that the second E is written in bold and in orange there. Verbs like espérer, the irregularity is that the second E, so the E that has an accent aigu, turns into an accent grave for je, tu, il, and il au pluriel. So this irregularity is only for first, second, third person singular, and then third person plural. Nous and vous remain unchanged. I'm going to read that conjugation table out and pay attention to the difference of pronunciation of that second accented E for je, tu, il compared to nous and vous. Espérer. J'espère, tu espères, il espère, nous espérons, vous espérez, ils espèrent. And that is the difference of pronunciation between E, accent aigu, and E, accent grave. Je répète, and you may repeat after me. Espérer, j'espère, tu espères, il espère, nous espérons, vous espérez, ils espèrent. Let's take a look at this a little bit further. This is an example. Aller au cinéma, and the verb is espérer. That's the infinitive of the verb. That's the infinitif, the form that is not conjugated, the form that ends in ER. The irregularity is that the E accent aigu turns into an E accent grave, and again, for first, second, third person singular, je, tu, il, and third person plural, il au pluriel. So the answer would be, on espère aller au cinéma, espère, E-S-P-E, accent grave, R-E. Pardon. Second group, verbs like acheter. What's the irregularity here? Look at the conjugation table. What do you notice? Yes, there's an accent that magically appears. But yet again, it appears for first, second, third person singular, je, tu, il, and third person plural, il au pluriel. Nous and vous remain unchanged. And again, you can hear that difference in pronunciation. Répétez après moi. Acheter. J'achète. Tu achètes. Il achète. Nous achetons. Vous achetez. Ils achètent. French grammar is very reassuring in those ways, is that you're going to have exception and rules, but you're going to see them applied all the time. Now, we already see that this second group of verbs, it's the same thing. It's only je, tu, il au pluriel, and nous and vous remain unchanged, and this is going to be repeated yet again. Exemple. Vous, une pizza pour dîner. Infinitif, c'est acheter. Irrégularité, E devient E accent grave pour la première, deuxième, troisième personne du singulier et la troisième personne du pluriel. Réponse. Vous achetez une pizza pour dîner. Oh wait, it's not irregular. No, it's not because nous and vous don't change. Okay? The accent appears, the accent grave appears only for first, second, third person singular, je, tu, il, and third person plural. Third group. Verbs ending in ayer, A-Y-E-R. And those are verbs like essayer or payer. And as you can see here from the table, the Y turns into I again for first, second, third person singular and third person plural. Je, tu, il au pluriel. So you also, again, that schema that's being repeated. Okay? Nous and vous do not change. Exemple. Tu de parler français. You're trying to speak French. Infinitif essayer. Irrégularité, Y devient I pour la première, deuxième, troisième personne du singulier et la troisième personne du pluriel. Réponse. Tu essaies de parler français. We change the Y to I because we're conjugating to here, the second person singular. Last group, I swear, verbs ending in G-E-R, which I've already been using a lot because everybody's been using manger already, to eat. Voyager is another one of those verbs, to travel. Oh wait, this is a little bit different, right? Look at the table. There is only one irregular form, and that is the new form. Again, the explanation is traced to the pronunciation, because if you hear the infinitive, voyager, that's a soft G, G, voyager. Je voyage, tu voyages, il voyage. All good. We keep that soft G sound because when a G is followed by an E in French, it's pronounced J. Okay? Je voyage, tu voyages, il voyage. However, because the ending for nous is O-N-S, if a G were followed by an O, the soft G sound would be lost and replaced by a hard G. Nous voyagons. Now it would be incredibly weird to go from voyager, je voyage, tu voyages, il voyage, nous voyagons. Nous vous voyagez, il voyage. That would be so strange that you insert an E there to keep that J. So, voyager, je voyage, tu voyages, il voyage, nous voyageons, vous voyagez, il voyage. Je, en Europe, infinitif voyager, irrégularité je devient je à la première personne du pluriel, je voyage en Europe. Doesn't change, because the only regular form here is the new form, the first person plural. And here, we're conjugating je, first person singular. This is time to end the mini lecture with a short self-graded quiz. You have 5 sentences here, okay? I suggest you pause the video before we correct so that you try it out, see if you remember, take your notes, read what's the irregularity, is it an accent change, is it an accent addition, is it A Y that turns into an I? Is it a GE? Check your notes and then we'll correct. Thank you for pausing this video. Let's take a look. Je, mes grands-parents chez le docteur, emmener, like acheter, has an E that turns into an accent grave. J'emmène mes grands-parents chez le docteur. Nous nageons dans la mer, and we all know that to keep nageons, you need to add an E. Ils préfèrent les hôtels de luxe. Ils préfèrent les hôtels de luxe, E accent grave. Elles essaient de parler une langue étrangère. Elles essaient de parler une langue étrangère. E-2-S-A-I-E-N-T. Tu espères avoir A en cours de français. Espère avec un accent grave. So, let's say each sentence was worth 2 points. Okay? If you have one mistake or less, if you have 8 or 10 out of 10, you're fine. You understood how the stem irregular changes here work. Okay? If you have 2 mistakes or more, so if you scored 6 points or less on this self-graded quiz, watch this video again. Okay? This will help you save time for class this week and help you learn this for the unit test. Thank you for listening. Merci beaucoup et bonne semaine. Au revoir.